Welcome to audio video system playlist. I, Professor Itesh Dholakia, is going to explain you LED television system. LED means light emitting diode television system. So to understand LED television system, these are my session outlines.
So first, I'll explain basics of LED television system. After that, I'll explain different types of LED television system which is available in the market. After that, I'll explain working of LED television system, and then after we will see structure of LED television system, and then we will discuss some advantages and disadvantages which is there with LED television system, and at the end I'll explain applications of LED television system. So let us begin this session with first agenda, that is basics of LED television system. Now, before I start with this session, I should give you some basic information which is there regarding LED television system. See, LED television system is nothing different than LCD television system. LCD television system and LED television system both are same. Only thing is, in LCD television system, in backlight, we use CCFL light. While in case of LED television system, in backlight we use LED light. So here only this difference is there in between LCD television system. So you can see my previous session based on LCD television system, then it will be very easier to you to understand this session based on LED television system. So what is the basic difference in between LED television and LCD television? LCD television system and LED television system both are same, only in LED television system as a backlight we use LED and in LCD television system as a backlight we use CCFL light. So see, LED television is actually LCD television system, but instead of CCFL as a light source, CCFL means cold cathode fluorescent light. So instead of CCFL as a light source, we use LED as a backlight in LED TV. Otherwise, one can say LED television is LCD television with LED as a backlight. That even one can say. See, LED is more energy efficient than CCFL. That's why people were using LED television compared to LCD with CCFL as a backlight. So that will make LED screen more slim and with lighter weight, and it will be more energy efficient. So LED TV screen, that is more slim, it is having very light weight as well as it is more energy efficient. So you'll be finding LED TV are very slim. Technically we can say LED backlight LCD television system, as only as a backlight instead of CCFL we use LED. Otherwise LED TV is LCD TV only. Only backlight is LED. So let us see some different types of LED television system. See, LED television is having three different categories. One is age LED television, and these are very thin and slim due to lighting is done at age only. So if you see the back layer, means last layer of television, then in that last layer we use light source, and on edge LED, only on edges you'll be finding lights are there. So because of LEDs are there on the edges, it is very thin and slim, right? Now see, second category is dynamic RGB LED. Now see, dynamic RGB LED, that is having LED on entire screen in backside, right? So array of LED is there in backside, but it is having one facility. It is dimming light more precisely. Like see, for example, if you have one image in which there is darker portion and lighter portion. So in darker portion, there will be light dimming which is happening, and in brighter portion, there will be bright light which is happening because of LED. So dynamic RGB LED is there with LED array. So there is smart light dimming facility, which is there with dynamic RGB LED system, and complete array of LED is there in dynamic RGB LED. And third category is full array LED. So in that you will be finding structure is similar to dynamic RGB LED, but there is no light dimming facility. So no capacity for localized dimming. So for some particular area, if you want to dimming the light in that case, that is not possible by this full array. So this full array LED will consume more power compared to dynamic RGB LED. And this full array LED will be provided with fixed power to all LED array, which is there in this complete display. So you can see this is full array. So in full array, so many LEDs are on, right? This is what edge LED. So on the edge only there is LED, you can see. And this is direct, or one can say dynamic RGB LED, in that whatever LED is required to give that brightness, in that case you'll be finding those LED which is required, those are only giving light. All LEDs are not actually getting turned on, right? Otherwise LEDs are placed, as over here you can see, on full array, but few LEDs are only on. So targeted area will get dimming precisely by having dynamic RGB LED, that is even referred as direct LED system. Now the working principle. So working principle is same. It is working similar to LCD television. It works based on blocking of light and it does not emit light. And LCD is there, right? Liquid crystal display is there. Only thing is, as a backlight, we do have LED, and LCD does not emit light. It is just blocking light. And based on orientation of molecule which is there with liquid crystal, light will appear on the display. So electrical signal will be given to liquid crystal by using electrodes, and orientation of liquid crystal will get changed, and based on that color will appear. So polarized light will pass through it. So blocking of light is being done based on electrical signal applied to liquid crystal by using electrodes. So if you see the structure, so structure is pretty similar to the structure which is there with LCD television system. You can see this is what backlight, and as a backlight we have LED backlight. You can see these are the LEDs. So white color light is being generated by this LED backlight. Now in this LED backlight there are three categories. This is what array LED structure, and even one can say this is even dynamic RGB structure. But in dynamic RGB structure, selected LEDs will get turned on, so light dimming is possible and we can save more power. While in case of edge LED structure, only these borders are having LED, and in center you don't need any LED connection, right? So less LEDs are connected on edge LED structure, so those are slim on display. And rest of the structure is similar to LCD TV. Then after there will be glass polarized film, then after there is negative electrode, then after there is LCD liquid crystal display, then again there is positive electrode, then after again there is glass filter, and in front there is glass cover. So based on orientation of this liquid crystal, light will pass through this liquid crystal and different color will appear over here. And signal will be given to this liquid crystal by using this positive and negative electrodes. And based on electrical signal, orientation of molecules of this liquid crystal will get changed, and that will provide different colors on the display. So this is how structure and functioning is been there. So advantages of LED TV. So see, it consumes less power compared to plasma, LCD and CRT. It is thinner and lighter compared to CRT, LCD as well as plasma TV. Contrast is way better than LCD. It is having very good brightness. One can say highest brightness is there with LED TV. Even compared to OLED TV, OLED TV, LED TV is having higher brightness. Now disadvantages of LED TV. See, it requires additional light source. It is having limitation of temperature. So you cannot operate to higher temperature, otherwise LED panel may get damage. Narrow viewing angle is there compared to OLED TV. Angle of viewing is very narrow in LED TV. There is little motion blur which is there with LED TV, and with LCD TV there is very higher motion blur. So motion blur is getting decreased little bit, but still there is somewhat motion blur which is there with LED TV because of liquid crystal which is there in LED TV display panel. But you will be finding LED TV is having less motion blur compared to LCD. Now let us see some applications which is there with LED TV. So we can use this LED display on laptop screen. We can use this in cell phones. We can use that on camera display. We can use that on television. Portable video game is even having some display as LED display. And in optical imaging, we can use this. So these are the applications which is there in LED television.
Thank you so much for watching this video. I would like to get your suggestions from your side. The reason is I want all those topics that has to be covered on my channel so that students can easily learn everything which is required in their university courses. And you can download all this material which I am teaching here from my application Engineering Funda. So I am providing all those material free of cost. You can download it. It will be easier to you to learn all those topics which I am teaching here. Again, thank you so much for watching this video, and your suggestions are most welcome to me. So please do give your valuable suggestions, which is highly required here to optimize this channel.